Good day. Let us discuss philosophy. When we hear the word philosophy, what comes to our mind? In Filipino context, when we hear this word, especially yung pilosopo, no, meron siyang negative connotation, no? Example, sumakay yung bata sa jeep, no? Nakisiksik siya dun sa punong-punong pasahero ng pampasaherong jeep. And sabi nung katabi, sisiksik ka pa dito, eh sikip na nga. And then sabi nung bata, eh saan ho ba talaga tayo sisiksik? Hindi nga po ba sa siksik na? No? So, pilosopo siya. No? There are times, nasasabihan tayo natin mga magulang, relatives, no, or even elder, kapag inulit natin yung statement nila at pabagyang patanong or critical analysis natin, sinasabihan tayo na pilosopong bata. Well, actually, that is one of the activities of philosophy at marami pa, no? By the end of this discussion, we will define the word philosophy, recognize the value of philosophical inquiry, and articulate questions that probe the deeper aspects of philosophical ideas and concepts. Walang masamang magtanong, no? Kasi pag tayo nagtatanong, dun lumalabas or nag-generate yung bagong knowledge. And even, china-challenge natin yung binigay na definition or concept sa atin, no? I can give you a simple analogy, no, dito sa philosophy, no? Before we begin dun sa mismo definition. Para sa mga STEM students or learners, makikita nila itong nasa picture na to na it's composed of H2O and oxygen, no? Para man sa mga EBM, with a capitalist lens, no, maaari nilang ibenta ito na ng nagkakahalagang 5 piso, no? Para man sa mga humanities and social science students, it could be a sustenance of basic needs, no? Water could be a source of flood or cause of flood, no, calamities. It symbolizes, no, yung water. Para naman sa mga pessimist, half empty siya, no? Or napansin na agad nila agad yung kulang. Para sa mga optimist naman, half full, may water, no? Napansin nila yung water. Sa philosophers, ma-define nila at masasabi nila, mapapansin nila lahat ng mga nabanggit. Holistic perspective sa philosopher, no? And another example, if we were asked, what makes chair a chair? Sabi natin, apat ang paa? Wood, kulay brown, no? How about pag siya ay naging black? Chair pa rin ba siya? Kung na-define natin nung una ay brown siya. So, well, it satisfies, no? Kasi merong apat na paa. Wood pa rin, sabihin natin. Kulay black lang, pero it's still a chair. So sabi natin, apat na paa, brown and black, wooden. How about pag naging steel na siya? At iisa yung rod or yung paa, yung stand, no? Baka classify pa kaya natin siya na chair, na bago yung design, no? Yun yung philosophy doon, no? Merong hindi nagbabago sa thought process natin at ito yung nag-justify na it's still a chair, no? So, we will discuss this sa iba't ibang branches ng philosophy, no? Pythagoras is the one who first used the word philosophy. He claimed that he is a philosopher. So it means, before Pythagoras, mga pre-Socratic philosophers, si Thales, Empedocles, Anaximander, Anaximenes, Heraclitus, they do not call themselves as philosopher. They just inquire, no, questions sa palengke, sa agora, sa marketplace, sa senatus, no, sa politicians, sa mga kapwa nila Greeks, no, and they do not use the word philosopher. It is Pythagoras who first used the word philosophy. So he's particular sa atin, no. He introduced a Pythagorean theorem, no. Well, actually, philosophy is the mother of all disciplines, no, math, science. Lahat ng subjects na kinukuha natin or core subjects natin, nag-root siya sa philosophy. No? So he claimed that there are three reasons why we are studying philosophy. First, lovers of gain. Ito yung mga nagpupuso ng study to gain professional development, to gain personal fulfillment, no? There are times may mga individuals who pursue master's degree, PhD, wanted to become a lawyer, a senator, politician, a priest, no? So, gain, no? So, yung reason nito kung bakit they want to study philosophy is to, bukod sa academic achievement, no? To pass the course requirements, is to, of course, build their personal and professional growth, no? Lovers of honor, ato yung the one who would like to ask questions, no? Looks intelligent in the public places to be respected, no? Ato yung mga nag-articulate, nagtatanong, nakikipag-debate, nakikipag-talastasan, nakikipag-usap, no? Sa iba't ibang tao sa lipunan, no? And they want to be respected in the sense na through the art of philosophy, nag-gain nila yung honor na yon, no? Kasi they introduce knowledge, they question yung ano yung nag-appear sa lipunan, no? Yung realidad, no? Yung criticism or critical analysis sa lipunan. Yung lovers of wisdom, ato yung someone is thirst for knowledge. They keep on questioning, no? They study philosophy, they study postgraduate studies kasi gusto nilang matuto, no? Yun yung self-fulfillment nila. To learn more. They are not satisfied dun sa mga natutunan nila, no? They want to generate new knowledge, no? So if your reason remains to I want to study this because I want to pass the subject philosophy of the human person sa senior high school, then it could be an indication of lovers of gain. But if you wanted to enrich your knowledge, no? It could be a sign of lovers of wisdom, no? If you want to become a lawyer someday, or a priest, or a philanthropist, it could be gain, honor, no? But if you want to generate or contribute something to the society, then I could say that this is a lovers of wisdom, no? Let's proceed with the etymological definition of philosophy, no? So technically, based sa historical facts, nag-originate ang philosophy sa Greece, no? So the reason why we use Greek symbols, no? Philos and Sophia. Philos means lover or friend. Ang Sophia naman ay wisdom. So we are lovers or friends of wisdom. And according to some philosophers, no, atong wisdom na to ay belongs to God. Siya lang ang may wisdom. Ang meron tayo ay knowledge. We share, we ask, we subscribe to that wisdom at yung nalalaman natin or nasasabi natin, ato ay knowledge, no? Siya lang yung nag-own ng wisdom, no? The reason why there are philosophers who really separated from the existence of God, they are technically not to be called philosophers, usually existentialists, no? Or atheists. So when it comes to technical, no, philosophy is the study of beings in their ultimate causes, principles, reasons, and acquired by the aid of human reason alone. No? We will study soul, truth, freedom, death, God, evil, logic, knowledge, no, aesthetics, metaphysics, no. We will define a thing through the aid of human reason alone. What does this mean? It's been walang ibang biases, walang ibang factors, no? Hindi defined culturally, politically, religiously, no? Societal, hindi, no? Ide-dissect natin siya na maging pure reason na ito yung definition ng isang bagay, no? Na fair siya sa lahat, no? And that is philosophy. So this is an example na mapapansin natin ano yung essence ng philosophy. Art of questioning, no? If you will ask someone, bakit ka nag-aaral? So sabihin nila, well, para makapagtapos. Ba't kailangan makapagtapos? Sabihin niya, bakit para makapagtrabaho. Bakit kailangan makapagtrabaho? Para may makain. Bakit kailangan may makain? Para mabuhay. Bakit para mabuhay? Sabihin natin, kung yung bata ay matanong, ah, ang dami mo naman tanong, no? Tama na. Actually, that is an art of philosophy, no? Art of questioning. We are not satisfied dun sa binibigay na sagot. We want to generate knowledge, no? So dun sa walang katapusang questions, ating tinatawag natin sa philosophy na infinite regress of justification. At pag di na lang natin alam yung sasagot natin sa tanong, ah, tama na, ang dami mo ng tanong. That is why Plato once said, there's only one thing I know. I know that I know nothing. No? Kasi pag hindi na natin masasagot yung tanong, doon na pumapasok yung philosophy. Naghahanap tayo ng mag-fit at magsasatisfy na definition doon sa tanong natin. No? If we will be asked by someone else, no? Ano ito? No? I-define natin siya, example sa science, no? Sa history, English, Filipino, base sa textbook. Pero pag tinanong tayo, keep on questioning, ah, bakit, mag-end up tayo, hindi rin pala talaga natin alam. At yung binigay natin na definition ay base sa nabasa natin, sa libro, sa nakita natin, no? Kaya sabi ni philosopher Plato, wala akong nalalaman kung totoo siya, no? So, going back, no, sabi ni Pythagoras, it is really impossible for human being to know everything because this possibility is only available to God. Kaya tayo nagsusubscribe sa wisdom kay God, no? Philosophy, lovers of wisdom, no? Yung alam natin, that is knowledge, no? Yung kinukuha na natin, hinihinga natin, sinusubscribe natin, wisdom, and it belongs to God, no? Let's try to philosophize atong title ng subject, no? As we all know, there are times sa mga old textbooks, merong tinatawag na philosophy of man, philosophy human person, philosophical anthropology, no? I-try natin i-philosophize yung title, no? At meron ding textbook na Filipino, Pilosophiyang Pantao. So usually questions are more important than answers. We question the question, no? Sa day-to-day life, we answer the question. In philosophy, we even question the question, no? We even question the statement, no, given na yan. Pero yung question to question, something different siya, no? A deeper scale, no? So, philosophy is merely or not really a subject. It is an activity, no? It becomes part of our life, ha? Parte ng buhay natin siya. It's a daily activity. Yun na yung thirst of knowledge, no? Yung third definition ng philosophy, no? So one does not simply study it, one does it every day, no? Example natin, no? Philosophy of man is not the same with philosophy of the human person. Bakit kaya, no? Sa contemporary definition ng man, lalaki, no? So pag ibig sabihin, pag subject pala natin ngayon, philosophy of man, no? Palalabasin natin ng mga babae, bakit philosophy of man yung pag-uusapan natin? To be fair, with gender sensitivity, male and female din, no? Philosophy of the human person, no? Gagamitin natin. Kasi human person symbolizes a person with complete structure, no? Entity, no? Psychologically, emotionally, spiritually, bodily, no? So, kompleto siya, no? So, philosophy of a human person is not the same with philosophy of the human person, no? Bakit? Philosophy of a human person ay specific sa isang tao lang. No? Where in fact, sa philosophy of the human person, yung universal approach. No? Kung pag-aaral natin ay philosophy ni Plato, that is philosophy of a human person. Kung pag-aaral natin yung philosophy ni Aristotle, that is philosophy of a human person. Kasi tinutukoy natin specifically yung philosophy ni Plato ni Aristotle. But dito sa course na to, we study the philosophy of the human person. Marami, group of people, group of philosophers from pre-Socratic to contemporary, no? Philosophical anthropology and philosophy of the human person is the same, no? Bakit? Kasi anthropos, study of a human person, no? and philosophical, no, is the same with philosophy of the human person, no?